What's up, guys? This is HH Trader back with another Street Smart Edge tutorial video. So in this video, we're going to be going over one of the most important parts in Charles Schwab, which probably should have been the first video, but the first video is charts. So you need your charts in order to use this other part of or tool of Street Smart Edge. This tool is the all-in-one trading tool. We're going to get into it right now. So the all-in-one trading tool is an amazing tool that will allow you to place your orders and manipulate all of the different functions of placing an order. How do we get to that? So what we want to do is go up here to launch tools here. We'll go to all-in-one trade tool. Okay, we'll click that. It'll bring up our all-in-one here. You can maximize it if you want to, and we'll go ahead and go over all the parts, but we're going to start off with the most important parts, and then I'll go over some of the more minute details later. So for the first part, because this is pretty much what people come to look at a lot when they come to Street Smart Edge, is the all-in-one tool, is the level two, right? You have your level two and your time and sales. So let's go ahead and manipulate our times and sales to do something for us that I think really works well for me to know when sellers are coming in and when buyers are coming in. So we can go ahead and put our cursor on our level or on our time and sales here, and we can right click. And when we right click, it's going to give us a little dialog box here, right? And so let's go ahead and hit the market depth settings. And in the market depth settings, you can decide what you want your time and sales or your level two to show to you. In the first section, you can see the market depth behavior. And so you can actually line up these numbers or these positions or shares that are sitting out here to be filled by size. So if a lot of people are buying at 265 and you have it lined up at 265 and it's the top of the bid, it'll be at the top here. If you do it by time, all of the orders that come in at 1837 will be up here, but it won't show you which value is being bought at the most. So for me, size is what matters here. And then over here, we have the display scroll bars. You can actually select this if you want a visible scroll bar on your level two at all times. Either way, I would say leave this one unchecked because you can just scroll anyway unless you just really want to see the scroll bar there. But I'm all about space management because I do use one screen to trade. So I'm not, every inch matters, you know. The next thing is the display aggregated quotes, another thing that I do not use. It pretty much breaks up this quotes into two sections. And I'm not even going to show it to you because it just is too confusing. It's convoluted. You can go into it if you want. The next one that I do use to save space is the display quote volume in hundreds. So let's say, let's cancel this. Let's say we pull this over a little bit, and we can see that we have a order or shares out here to be bought at the 265. We have 6,248 shares. Well, if I wanted to save space, I could show this as 100. Okay, so let's go ahead and do that. We'll right click and go back to our market depth settings, and we'll click this box that says display quote volume in hundreds. We'll hit okay. And now that 6,000 is now 62. So we now saved a little bit of space there. But if space doesn't really matter and you're not eating for space, I mean, you could just leave it as this one and press OK, and it'll just be 6,000. But hey, that's another space saving thing that you can do. data sources, I never mess with these. I always just leave those checked. Bid and ask columns. What do you want to see in these columns? I never have the venue in there. Never have the quote change arrow. The quote change arrow will just show you, well, I can just click it and show you okay. So there are, when the market is open, the arrows will show you which way the bid and the ask are going. If the ask is going up, the arrows will be going up. If the ask is going down, the ask side will be going down. And it's a little arrow that pops up here, but the market isn't open right now, so it's not going to show it. I'll uncheck that. The next thing that you can show is the price, the size, the bid and ask status, and the bid and ask time. But remember, I am on a space crunch, so I really don't care about the time in my level two. So I get rid of that. I don't care about the status. All I care about is the price and the size. And let's go ahead and hit that. And it's going to kind of scrunch us in here. We kind of lost some values there. So let's go ahead and bring it back in. All you need to do is make this a little bit smaller. There we go. And realize that all of this black space is because I have this maximized right now. So if I take this down to a smaller size, you know, it's going to be a lot smaller. So we'll actually drag this over here so everything can be on screen. And look at that space management. All of our prices there, all of our sizes there, no times to worry about, and all of that. All right, let's go ahead and go back into the settings. We see the display in time and sales. So what do we want to see over here in the time and sales? We do not care about the time. Uncheck that. All I want to know is the bid and ask changes in my time and sales. And I'll hit OK. And so it got rid of that, and it's just going to show me the sizes there. And really and truly, you don't even need these. You really don't need these. All you need is the prices over here. And I'll show you how to manipulate these colors in just a moment. So let's go ahead and get rid of that bid and ask changes, because we can see the bid and ask changes over here. So why be redundant? These down here, watches, I never use. You can get into them if you want to. It's basically the order book that you're going to use to see what orders are being taken. And it already has the best one selected, so I wouldn't even mess with it. Now, if you are using multiple screens, you can actually apply, and let's say if you have an all-in-one on one screen, an all-in-one on another screen, an all-in-one on another screen, you have three, and you want to change all three of them at the same time, you can do that by applying to all instances, and it will apply them to all instances, and you press OK. But for right now, I only have one, so I'll click OK, and we'll bring this over, and this is pretty much all I need to see right there. That's pretty much my setup. Now, let's work on manipulating the colors in here first on the time and sales, so we can know, hey, is this, where is this action? Are these buyers? Are these sellers? Are people, where is the action? Is it above the bid, below the bid, or what? So to do this, we'll right click again, and we have this feature here in our dialog box called colors. We'll hit colors. And it's going to, let me move this over a little bit. Okay, colors. And we'll move this over here a little bit. So, what in the time and sales can tell us where buyers and sellers are moving? This is how my logic works. Okay, so this is how I know if it's sellers or buyers. If trades are happening below the bid, okay, people are really, really having a lot of action under the bid, either two things can be happening. Buyers are getting in, or sellers are dumping. All right. So that's why I like to have trades at the bid, or I mean below the bid, at red. All right. So if it's happening below the bid, I believe that it's going to be red, right? So that's sellers, either people are dumping or buyers are trying to get in. And if we know that the theory of the market is to buy low and sell high, more experienced traders are going to be getting in low, right? And so if there's a lot of action below the bid, either it's going to be a dip down from the seller selling short and pushing the price down, or buyers will catch that price down there while it's red and go for the rise. So that's trades below the bid. And if you don't know what the bid is, let me know in the comment section. I can do something, a video on that. At the bid is pretty much a midway point. People sit at the bid. People want to buy at the bid. And why is that? Because the bid is the optimal price for entry, pretty much. No one wants to buy the ask because the sellers are sitting up there. Let's say if the sellers are sitting at two. Actually, you know what? I guess I can go ahead and do the bid and the ask here just to go over it. So let's say we have 265 and this is our bid price where people actually want to buy. But the sellers want to sell up here at the 267. So that's $2 away from where we want to actually buy. If people are wanting, or if the sellers only want to sell up here, it's going to force the buyers to go up there to buy, right? It's going to push the price higher, right? If the sellers are dumping, they don't want the stock anymore. It's moved up so much, got too extended, and they're ready to sell at any price below where they're at right now. They'll come down and sell at the bid. They're trying to sell quickly, and this is a very dangerous thing. And this is why I say that over here on our colors, that below the bid should be red, because if it's going below the bid, it's two things. The sellers are getting rid of what they're trying to take profit. Okay, they're getting out. Now, as they're taking profit, it could give you an opportunity for entry as that price comes down. But you need to understand the patterns of the market and reading the chart as well as what's going on the level two. You can't just use one. You'll get absolutely killed. All right, so that's below the bid. At the bid, I usually just put gray. It's usually grayed out because I really don't care about at the bid. I really don't care about trades inside the bid and ask. I don't care about trades at the ask. But trades above the ask, I put in green, right? Why is that? Because let's say if the ask is at 267, but people are willing to buy at this price and above it. So they're buying, let's say if they're buying at 267.25, 267.50, they believe that this stock is worth more than what's at the bid and the ask. So they're buying above the ask, right? And so you remember the old adage, sell high or buy low, sell high, right? And so these people that are buying on the green could easily get dumped on by the sellers that have already placed their positions higher. Okay, so let's say if the sellers were sitting at the 270, right? That's $3 away. It gets up there and they're buying above the ask, pushing the price higher, 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 all the way to the 270s, and the shorts hit it hard at the 270s. You're going to see a major drop because those people see the seller sitting out here on the level two. Let's say a big size like, well, this one has hidden sellers here. These little low numbers are usually hidden sellers. When you see like a one out here during the market, if there's a lot of volume going and you see a very low number, usually those are hidden either sellers or buyer positions. So you have to be careful of those on the level two. But when the sellers hit it, it goes immediately from this green back through all of the gray, and then you see the red. So this is how I have my colors set up. Above the ask is green, below the bid is red, and then in between, I really just do not care. I just don't. It just doesn't matter to me. But let's go ahead and hit okay. And I don't know if it'll make any changes here right now because the market isn't open, but it'll make changes during the market open. All right, back out, or wait, back to the colors. All right, quote changes here. So quotes are basically the orders that are actually going through. So over here on the level two are orders that are just sitting in wait, right? They're not orders that have happened yet. On the time and sales, these orders are actually going through and being filled. So don't get tricked up. If you see 265.02 over here on your level two, but you're not seeing it over here on your times and sales, it may be a sign that those orders are not getting filled. The level of confidence hasn't reached that level of shares yet. All right. The next thing, you can always manipulate the font in here, what kind of font color that you want on your level twos as well. It really doesn't matter for historical trades. I usually leave this stuff alone. Quote changes, background, you can change this to white, a white background in your times and sales. It's really just black always works for me. Over here on the market depth, you can actually manipulate your colors here as well. I don't care about any of these, pretty much any of this gradient stuff. I could pretty much just change everything to white. I don't care about the gradient. As long as I know what's the top level mover, that's all I really need to see. So get rid of all that, press OK. And you can see the top. If you want to highlight the top, which is the tier one orders, you can easily change that to something that's real visible, you know, like tier one right there. And just right there, you can easily look and say, okay, what is at the top of my orders? And you can always manipulate those however you want to. All right, font, we can always change the font however we want. If it'll give me the drop down here, there it is. They have a couple of different drop down patterns that you, or features that you can use here. Whatever you want, you can change it to a bigger size just in case, you know, you use glasses or something like that. You can definitely make your font bigger. And you can bold and you can italicize, right? And you can also apply to all instances if you want. Now see, this is the 29 font here. So definitely quite big there. Alright guys, so that was the video for today. This was the part one to the all-in-one trading tool. In later videos, we're going to be diving in a little bit deeper into some of the other features of the trading tool. You can check out the rest of the content here on Framework Fortune. You can check out my channel at HH Trader, or you can check out my Twitch channel at hhtrader.tv. I will be streaming in the morning starting at 8 o'clock Central Time and working my way on in doing the morning analysis and seeing what we have to trade. Anyway, don't forget to like and subscribe. Again, thank you guys for tuning in. And in the next one, we'll be diving in a little bit deeper into this thing. But that is it. And as always, I will see you in the next one. Peace.